The Irishman, directed by Martin Scorsese. I have already made a video on The Irishman, and so I would love it if you would check it out. But this film focuses on the life of mobster Frank Sheeran, played amazingly by Robert De Niro. This film does have great performances and talks about regret and friendship. You should definitely give it a watch. It's on Netflix. Shazam, directed by David S. Sandberg. Shazam is very lighthearted and is a great DC film. And the character Billy Batson's character arc is to accept his new family that loved and welcomed him. Now, the VFX ain't that great, but even the villain Savannah is written really well and performed really well too. It's one of the best DC films yet. War, directed by Siddharth Anand. War is actually a pretty good movie. Hrithik and Tiger facing off in the same movie is a delight to watch. The action is great and the two actors are fantastic in their roles, acting-wise and stunt-wise. The twists and turns were shocking and it continues to entertain you. Chichore, directed by Nitesh Tiwari. Chichore is one of the most heartfelt films of 2019. It focuses on the lives of seven college friends and talks about friendship and teaches us that our results don't define us, our effort does, and I think that is a beautiful message. Give my video a watch. Alita Battle Angel, directed by Robert Rodriguez. Alita is one of the best sci-fi films of last year. The action and CGI looks amazing and Alita, played by Rosa Salazar, was amazing. But this film teaches us about the destructive consequences of obsession and how it shouldn't consume us. It is a really exciting film. Joker, directed by Todd Phillips. This film shows us the tragedy of Arthur Fleck and how he beats back the society that trashed on him by embracing his mad side and becoming the Joker. The score, the visuals and performances are really great. You should definitely give it a watch. It's on Amazon Prime Video. Parasite, directed by Bong Joon-ho. Parasite focuses on the lives of two families of different classes, the rich and the poor. This movie perfectly shows us the consequences of class conflict and how the poor family slowly and carefully leech on the rich family and get new jobs. Make sure to check out my video on Parasite on the channel. Toy Story 4, directed by Josh Cooley. Toy Story, I think, is a pretty solid movie. Although I wish that the other characters like Buzz and Jessie got more screen time, it has a great character arc for Woody to be free of ownership. Even the antagonist Gabby Gabby's character arc is beautiful to watch. Avengers Endgame, directed by Joe and Anthony Russo, was the cinematic conclusion to 22 movies and several characters. I'm so glad that this was the film that finished the Infinity Saga. The CGI was phenomenal, although I wish the color palette was more saturated rather than dull and grey. But the characters and time travel was really entertaining and is one of the best MCU movies till date. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, directed by Quentin Tarantino, this movie really transports you to the 1960s Hollywood and has some incredibly fun performances from Brad Pitt and Leo DiCaprio. It shows the struggle of Rick Dalton, played by Leo DiCaprio, into fitting into the new Hollywood, and Cliff Booth is just messing with the murderers. Check out my video on this film. Marriage Story, directed by Noah Baumbach. Marriage Story is a heartfelt and heartbreaking movie. It shows us the unstable relationship between Adam Driver and Scarlett Johansson. Both of them give amazing performances. The dialogues feel real and it focuses on how a relationship requires love and commitment and support. Give it a watch. Uri the Surgical Strike, directed by Aditya Dhar. This film focuses on Vihan Shergill, played by Vicky Kaushal, and how he leads a military operation to terminate the Pakistani soldiers that killed their men. This film makes you feel patriotic and the action feels real and gritty because of its handheld nature. In the end, you feel satisfied and how the Josh scene just gives you goosebumps. 1917, directed by Sam Mendes. 1917 is a World War I film, shot in such a way that it makes it feel like it's one take, with no cuts. This might cause some distraction as you search for hidden cuts, but other than that, this film is about two soldiers on the run to deliver a message to stop an attack. The cinematography of this film looks beautiful. Make sure to check my video on this film. Super 30, directed by Vikas Bahl. Super 30 focuses on Anand Kumar and how he teaches the less privileged children who have the talent and potential but are denied the resources. Anand teaches them and gets them into IIT. We see the struggle and it's really engaging. Although the songs are forgettable and love interest is pointless, in the end, it feels like we've been with them on their journey. Peta, directed by Karthik Subbaraj. If you know me, I am a huge fan of Rajinikanth and his charisma is infectious. It really is entertaining and the gangster aspect is pretty cool. Nawazuddin Siddiqui is in this film and is really good, although he isn't menacing enough. Not an acting problem. Otherwise, the cinematography of this film with its yellow and blue contrast look stunning. A very entertaining Rajini gangster film. Badla, directed by Sujoy Ghosh. Badla is one of the best Indian crime thrillers, although I am aware it is a remake of the Spanish film The Invisible Guest. It is a remake well done. Amitabh Bachchan is a true gem of Indian cinema. Now, I won't ruin this film for you, but it focuses on solving a murder case and how Tapsee Pannu's character is trying to get herself out of all this trouble. The twists are shocking and Amitabh Bachchan rapping is what I didn't know I needed. So yeah, these are the bunch of films that released in 2019 that I really like. I know I haven't watched a lot of other films and I really apologize for that. I just don't have a lot of the time. But when I do find time, I'll make sure to watch them. And make sure to comment down below your favorite list of films that released in 2019. And yeah, and until next time, I'll see you later.